this section. I gotta read that. That's a dope little section. But yeah, I got a bunch of books that I still gotta tap into. Yeah. People ask me why I cut my mustache for the show. I gotta keep my mustache shaved for the show. But I mean, I can't really grow a mustache like that, so it really doesn't matter. Alchemist, one of my favorite books. Everyone knows this book. This is like a little basic book. I'm gonna tell you to read. You know what I'm saying? But it ain't basic though. So it's a good book. And it's a quick read. These are quick reads. I've read this before. I think I read this almost twice. The second time, I got halfway through it, but then my ADD started kicking in. This joint, really good book. Bridges, Man in Babylon. Read this one time. It's very symbolic, or you know, very the way it's put together is very, I don't know that word right now. My mind is blank. But it's a good book. See what y'all talking about. I can't really see them. Yeah, that's SpongeBob. Gotta watch SpongeBob, you know what I'm saying? Gotta have cartoons on. See, when you're creative, you always gotta have cartoons on. Always gotta have cartoons playing. Cartoons are a big inspiration in my life. I need cartoons. Cartoons keep my youth. Cartoons keep me happy. Cartoons is an escape from reality, like video games are. It's a very good book a fan gave to me. If you're in this live, thank you for this book. I've started reading it. I haven't finished it. The Destruction of Black Civilization. Thank you for this book. This is a gem right here that I need to finish. I really need to finish, and I will. That boy Melvin here, mad boy. I'm really, you feel me? I really read, bro. People be thinking I don't read. I know I got ADD. Oh, this the homegirl Tati book right here. My America, definitely cop this right here. Book of her poems. It's hard. What else I got over here? I got some more stuff. But it ain't nothing too crazy. Then I got this Marvel. Hold on, I'm gonna show you this one. This one thing I got. Hold on. I got this joint right here. Now, you know what I'm saying? If you don't know your history, you know what I'm saying? You gotta do your history. You know? Let me show y'all something. Let's see what I can find. Let me show y'all a little woo-wah. Hold on, let me show you. So basically in this joint, they got the, what they got in here is the black Iron Man is actually a woman that I'm looking very forward to seeing. Damn, I can't find her in this right now. Is she in this? People don't even know that, bro. Like people don't even know that. I'm definitely Marvel over DC. But,
you know, you gotta go to DC too, man. You gotta be educated.
Educate yourself. This is what they don't teach you in school. Marvel got all the stuff. Marvel got some, it's very symbolic. It got some stuff. Why am I blanking out right now? Some subliminals that they have, that they tell through the superheroes, which is super dope. I be in this book when I'm bored, just looking at superheroes and reading about them. It's always interesting how they change look-wise over the years. This is education. I don't care what y'all talking about. That's what they teach y'all in school. And that's the funny thing. In school, they don't even teach you everything you're supposed to know. They leave stuff out. And I ain't the one that told you that. Stay woke. They not teach you everything you're supposed to know in school. The superhero stuff is my history. I don't know about y'all. People be asking me what acting books I be reading. I got Heme. This is a really good one. I'm still trying to finish. Man, the Power of the Actor. Dramatic Circumstances. Solid book. Cool. I always think that it's cool to just have different books. I got Heme. Just basic acting tips. I just never finished this, but I was good to just have it on there, have it on you. These joints. This joint, you see how messed up this book is. This is, now this joint, look at bro, I was underlining. This is the first book. This is one of the first books I ever read as an actor. Look how I'm underlining that stuff. But I was trying to learn, boy. What else is in here? Highlighted stuff, like, boy, like this book right here. What's the shit? And then this, I still gotta read out of. This is a really good book. I still gotta read this. On purpose, it's a really good book, but I gotta read it. I gotta finish it. That's my only problem. I can never finish books. I gotta read it, and like, I can never really lock in all the time. I gotta read it in like random times and shit. Cause my bro, I don't pay attention and I check out early. That's why I hate small talk. That's why I hate going to industry parties. They always talk about stuff that you're not interested in, that you really don't want to hear, and they only talk to you because usually they have intentions and it's not genuine. But yeah. Oh yeah, I can't wait to see Black Panther. Nah, I'm not mad they ain't teaching me superheroes in high school. In high school, they don't teach you all the history you're supposed to know. That's the funny thing, bro. It's a lot of stuff that people don't know that they didn't learn in school. I mean, I think in college more now, they definitely teach you more about, you know, especially Black history and stuff, but it was hellish. I actually learned a lot of stuff out of high school than I did in high school. I'm gonna keep on it. Casey, what's up, man? Send me the songs. Send me the songs I wanna hear. Yeah, exactly. They don't want us to know. They're not gonna tell you everything in school. Why would they tell you everything in high school? They don't want you to know all that. That's just how it is. I'm just keeping it 100 with you. They teach you how to live in the rat race. And they teach you how to live in the rat race, and then that's it. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna get into it. I don't wanna be political. I don't feel like doing that, but I'll tell you, they ain't teaching you everything. That's what I'm about to tap into this book after I get off this live. And then I'm about to finish watching Dark Knight Rises. I didn't finish it last night. I'm my favorite movie. Yeah, always do. I definitely say do your own research. Read your own books. Everything I love. Thanks, Christian. These are actually prescribed. I really can't see them. What's up, G? Send it to my Sacramento number. Casey? Nah, I wish I spoke Spanish. That's another thing they don't teach us in American schools is different languages since we little. From when we young to when we grown up. My bad, I'm over here smacking. This payday is bracking. I think I'm nearsighted. That means I can't see far, right? Because I think that's what it is. But I love Grownish. Grownish is dope. I'm a fan of a lot of shows, man. I always look at shows as like, it's just very inspiring to see, you know, your peers and stuff working. I think that's always dope to see. And it just makes you remember that everything is possible, as cliche as that might sound. I mean, I'm at a point in my career when I've done stuff, but, you know, it's a marathon, and creatively you get kind of frustrated because you start falling in love with the craft more and you want to do other things within that craft, but you have to pay certain dues. And I feel like that's a place where everybody can go, like, have to do in their career. What's up, Nathan, bro? What's poppin'? What's up, everybody? the languages, I will learn some. I will want to learn some type of African language, and I would love to learn Spanish, and I would love to learn French, and yeah, that's about it. At the mall, okay, getting right. I don't know what I'm doing tonight. I'm about to meet with a homie later, a writing homie. We're trying to, you know, I got this idea that we're trying to get on paper. So we finna meet, have a little coffee, whatever, talk about that, meet about that. And then after that, shoot, I don't know what I'm doing. Might come back home, play video games, watch cartoons, watch, that's what I love to do. We did that algae thing last night, it was hella fun. Hoodie from, I think, where did I get this hoodie? Where's this hoodie from? I forgot where I got this from. I'll be buying stuff and be forgetting what store I'm in and stuff. Nah, I'm PS4 all day. PS4 all day, every day. I would love to go to Haiti. Somebody, my brother told me that my grandpa is, has some Haitian. I don't know how accurate that is. I have a problem with no people. If you ever hear somebody saying I got a problem with certain people, that is a lie. I was raised different. I was raised in a house where we don't do that. But you know, people is rumors, people gonna talk. You can't handle all of it. I mean, you can't control all the rumors. Oh, you said that my other phone is upstairs, Casey. When I go up there and check it, I'm gonna check out the songs. Much love, much love. The book that I was highlighting in, what's this one? Acting for the Camera by Tony Barr. I used to take this book everywhere, like, this hella messed up. I used to take this book with me when I was just a model. I remember doing Milan Fashion Week when I was walking for Calvin Klein. I was reading this, like, in between, because it was so boring at the fittings. Nobody talks, you know how models are. Nobody talks to each other. And then you got the models who's hella cocky, and they just want to talk about all the stuff they model in, and we all looking like, nobody cares. Anyways, but that's my book. Acting for the Camera, that's my favorite book. Acting wise. I would love to do Paris Fashion Week. I don't know if I am though, but I remember we went last year. It was one of the best times I ever had. It was so dope. TV, SpongeBob, of course. Always keep, like I said, always keeping the cartoons on. Got to. What's up, Patrick? I want to see what the other cartoon is on. But I usually like watching Boomerang. New cartoons in. I like SpongeBob though, but I don't like the new SpongeBob episodes. If somebody from SpongeBob working, watching this live, please don't take that seriously, but I miss the old SpongeBob. I liked his tone better. Like, they made his tone more high pitched than the new ones. The two new Drake songs are hella dope. Drake been doing it since I was in high school, to graduate high school. He's the guy.